Hello everyone, welcome in 11CHE. Today we are going to discuss about specific heat of liquids and solids. In the case of gases, there is also specific heat, but there is a condition of specific heat at constant pressure and specific heat at constant volume. So, what is the definition of specific heat? Here, how we will proceed? First, we will see the definition. What is the definition of specific heat? Then we will see the examples, and after example we will conclude or we will come at the this definition. Means we will try to identify that, or we will try to prove that how this definition came. So the definition of specific heat is amount of heat required to raise the temperature of unit mass by unit temperature is called the specific heat, right? So here what we are going to say, that how much amount of heat is required to raise the temperature of, suppose, unit mass. Unit mass means 1 kilogram of mass by unit temperature. Unit temperature means, suppose, 1 degree Celsius, right? This is a temperature which we have to raise. Means if we have to raise the temperature of 1 degree Celsius of 1 kilogram of any material, then how much amount of heat is required? This is called the specific heat. Okay, so here we can see that this is a quantitative relationship. What specific heat is? A quantitative relationship between amount of heat transferred or required and raise in temperature of a material. Now we are going to see that what is the meaning of this all about, right? So let's see. Here is the example one. Okay, so in example one we have two block, that is A and B. Suppose this is a block, and in this block there is a water. In block A there is a water, and in block B also there is a water, and for the same material compare the QA and QB. Means QA for this block and QB for this block for raising the temperature by 1 degree Celsius. So here is the basic common sense is that the amount of heat required to raise the temperature of 1 gram of water by 1 degree Celsius, okay, and here the amount of heat will be required to raise the temperature by 1 degree Celsius of 10 gram of water. Now for which block the amount of heat required will be high? So the QB of course will be higher for as compared to QA. Why? Because here you have to increase the temperature by 1 degree Celsius of 1 gram of water. So you will require the less heat as compared to block B, where there is a water of 10 gram and you have to raise the temperature by 1 degree Celsius. Got it? So what we can say, that we can say if the mass is higher, right? So the amount of heat will be required more. As simple as that. So this is the first example. Now here is a second example, and in this example for the same material, the material is same, compare the QA and QB for raising the temperature by plus 1 degree Celsius and 10 degree Celsius respectively. Means for block A, suppose in the block A and block A and in block B there is a water, right? But what is the condition is that, and the mass of the water is same, 1 gram and 1 gram. But in the previous case, there is the 10 gram of the block B water, right? The mass of the water was 10 gram. So here what is happening? For block A, we have to raise the temperature plus 1 degree Celsius. But in the case of, block B, we have to raise the temperature plus 10 degree Celsius, right? So the amount of heat will be required more for QB as compared to QA, as simple as that. Why? Because here we have to raise the temperature by 10 degrees Celsius. What is the formula of? The formula is mc delta T. Okay, so we are talking about the Q here, the amount of heat required. So if this delta is more, then simple, the Q will be high. If this delta is 1 as compared to 10, so you can assume or you can compare the QA and QB. So from here, what we can conclude, that we can conclude if the temperature difference, or if the temperature difference is high, so the amount of heat required will be also high for block A and for block B. This was our conclusion, right? Now there is a third example, and in this third example we have a different materials, right? The QA and QB, we have a different material, and now we have to compare QA and QB for raise the temperature by 1 degree Celsius, right? And the mass is also same. But what is the condition here? The condition is that the material is not same, right? There is a different material. Now what will happen, that the amount of heat required for A and the amount of heat required for B will be different. We cannot say that the QA and QB will be high, because we, first of all, we do not have the enough data to say that, and the second thing is the material is different. If that material would be same, then we would come to at any conclusion, right? What we can say, QA and QB will not be equal, right? So this is our third conclusion, where the material is different. Now for the specific heat, we will come to the definition and we will come to the formula. So from the our previous three examples, what would be the formula for specific heat? So first we will see the definition, first we will see the formula for heat supplied. Okay, and the formula for heat supplied is mass of a material. We see that the it also depends on the mass, where in the first example we had 10 gram of mass of water into temperature difference, also it depends on the temperature difference, right, into there is a material. This will not be the mass, it will be material, because it was also depend upon the material, right? So what we can say, that simply the formula will become Q is equal to m c delta T. This C is nothing but the material, and it will be the constant, and we will find its value by the experiment. So here this C is a specific heat, right? For our case, this is a specific heat. Now how will you define this C? So simply we can say that if we have m mass, if we have a mass of 1 kilogram, and that delta T will be 1 degree Celsius, so we can say that Q will be C. Means what is the meaning of that? It means that if we want to increase the temperature of 1 kilogram of any material by 1 degree Celsius, then the specific heat will be heat supplied, equal to heat supplied, right? So as simple as that. So by the definition of this and by the formula of this, we came into the this definition, and the definition was amount of heat required to raise the temperature of unit mass by unit temperature is called the specific heat, and that specific heat is nothing but the material, which we see from our examples, right? Now we see the note and we see the some key point for the specific heat. What are the key points for the specific heat? The first one is, it is a relationship between Q and T. We saw this our earlier examples as well as in the formula. First, whenever we talk about the sensible heat, okay, and that sensible heat means without phase change, means whatever we are talking about right now, वी आर टॉकिंग अबाउट द विदाउट फेज चेंज, वी आर टॉकिंग अबाउट फॉर द विदाउट फेज चेंज मीन्स देयर इज टेम देयर इज फेज इज नॉट चेंजिंग. इफ द फेज विल चेंज देन देयर इज अनदर कॉन्सेप्ट विल कम एंड वी विल टॉक अबाउट दैट एंड दैट कॉन्सेप्ट इज लेटेंट हीट. राइट, सो राइट नाउ वी आर टॉकिंग अबाउट द सेंसिबल हीट, स्पेसिफिक हीट वेयर द फेज इज नॉट चेंजिंग. इफ वी वट वी आर डूइंग हेयर, सपोज वी हैव टू रेज द टेम्परेचर बाई 10 डिग्री टू 30 डिग्री, सो वी आर टॉकिंग अबाउट दिस. सो वी आर नॉट टॉकिंग अबाउट दिस, सपोज 50 टू 150. सो इन द केस ऑफ वाटर, सपोज इन द केस ऑफ वाटर वी आर टॉकिंग अबाउट दिस राइट नाउ, वी आर नॉट टॉकिंग अबाउट दिस बिकॉज इन दिस केस देर इज द फेज विल चेंज. राइट, now how we can define the specific heat, we can write simply C is equal to Q divided by M delta T, and from here we can calculate the unit, and you know that unit is very very important for every like whatever the quantity we are discussing, the unit is very very important. So please let me in the comments box what will be the unit for specific heat in this case. Now the value of C depends on the temperature, as simple as that. You can see here this T is completely okay, so our specific heat is depends upon the temperature. Right, now the last conclusion is that greater the value of C, more the amount of heat required to raise the temperature by 1 degree Celsius. What is this means? It means that if the value of C is high, so the amount of heat required to raise the temperature will be high. Right? If the value of C will be high, suppose for any material, if we have C for one material that is 1 and for another material, suppose we have a C is 0.09. So the amount of heat required to raise the temperature by 1 degree Celsius for first case will be high as compared to this one. Right? So why it is happening? Because you can see this formula. As the C will increase, the Q will definitely increase. Right? So these are the some key points for the specific heat. Now, from the specific heat, there is a one concept also came, and that was heat capacity. Right? So, like for the specific heat, we were saying about the unit mass. Right? There was the mass was unity. Okay? We were talking about the unit mass. But in the case of heat capacity, we talk about the given mass. I hope I am clear to you. And the definition of heat capacity is amount of heat required to raise the temperature by 1 degree Celsius is called the heat capacity, and it is denoted by the C. Right? So what will be the definition of and what will be the formula of that C? The formula of that C will be C is equal to mass into specific heat, means M into C. Please do not confuse with this C and this C. I can simply write here the bar. Okay. This is a specific heat. So you can see here our heat capacity depends upon the mass here. From this definition, we can say that our C depends upon the mass, not in the temperature. Because if the mass will high, suppose there is a water, right? For the one case mass is 10 gram and for the second case the mass is 100 gram. So what will happen that the heat capacity will be high for the second case, right? If we want to raise the temperature by 1 degree Celsius. So we can say that heat capacity depends upon the mass, not in the temperature. Okay, so suppose this is the just a example. Suppose we have mass 10 gram or 100 gram. So we will simply see that the second case, for the second case, heat capacity will be high. And for the heat capacity, we talk about the given mass, means we have a mass, for a particular mass, we determine the amount of heat required, right? So, for today, we discuss about the specific heat and heat capacity, right? So, if you have any doubt in any particular topic and any particular examples, you can let me in the comments box. And if you have any doubt in any subjects, any topic, you can let me in the comments box. I'll make the video for you. And please let me in the comments box what will be the unit of C and what do you know more about the specific heat's key point. So, that's all for the today's video. Thank you for watching.